Introducing to you the newly released Realme GT Master 5G, the flagship phone of Realme that was just released here in the Philippines on October 1st and made available to consumers on October 2nd onwards. This comes in Snapdragon 778G versus the Samsung Ultra S21 5G's 888 Snapdragon. I don't know what the heck that means, but you know, higher number means better, isn't it? Not much of a difference, but this phone is a third of the price of S21, even a quarter. S21 starts at 65,000 pesos compared to the 8G RAM with 256GB memory for only 21,990 pesos. It has another variant of 8G with 128GB memory for 19,990 pesos. And don't forget to get the receipt when you purchase one, because that's going to come in handy when you need the warranty when you start using the phone. And this comes with the usual quick guide and the actual phone itself, obviously. I've already used this phone for about a day. And mind you, I didn't pre-order, even though I got this on the release date. I scouted the mall for about an hour and a half to get the Voyager Gray, because this color is very hard to find. The easier one to find is the Voyager Blue variant. But yeah, the more limited one that has the signature of that famous Japanese guy, I don't know what he does, maybe he's into fashion. I just think he's into fashion because of the handwriting. And aside from the phone, it also has the rubber casing, which almost kind of looks like the back finish of the actual phone, which is in leather. And then the charger, and also the charger of this phone comes in 65 watts, which is very, very gracious of Realme. The usual charger, like Samsung and iPhone, is the 25 watt charger. So the 65 watt charger can fully charge the phone in probably half an hour. It doesn't have headphones, so it's kind of in the trend with the other phones as well, wherein you don't really get much inside the box, you just get the charger. And some of them don't even give you the charger anymore, it's just the cord. We're not gonna say the name, but yeah, it's just the cord, the cable that they give you. And that one is almost 100,000 pesos, and you don't get a charger, just the cable. And to be honest, for not professional Android users, we haven't used an Android phone in 7 years, so this is the first time I'm gonna be using an Android phone again. So I even had to search for messages for a good minute. And this is Michelle trying to put on the rubber casing. Okay, we're still working on it. Yep. Okay, I've just clipped that part. The rubber casing has a similar look to the leather finish of the phone at the back. And here is Michelle trying out the video feature. This is actually the reason why we bought this phone, because S21 of Samsung has 64 megapixels for their back camera, and this one comes in 64 megapixels as well. And it has this really cool feature of being able to use both the front cam and the back cam at the same time. Yeah, and then this one is for zooming. And don't mind the message icon on the right side of it. And then this is me trying out the video feature of the phone. We won't be able to use 64 megapixels for video though. It doesn't let you use that lens. So I think this is the lower megapixel, but it actually looks pretty great. It actually looks 64 megapixel-y. It kind of looks better than the Sony camera resolution. But yeah, this one is in 4K setting. So yeah, let's make breakfast while we're trying out the phone for vlogging, since that's what we'll be using as a second camera moving forward. This is the back camera that we're using right now, and we are making pancakes. So this is the Korean pancake that we bought from a Asian grocery store. We don't often drink cow's milk because cow's milk, although it's healthy, it contains a huge amount of saturated fat, which is not good for your health. And we're making healthy smoothie here. So we put in the ice first, and then my leftover cucumber from last week. Slice them up because the osterizer couldn't chop them up anymore. And the phone really has a good zooming feature. As you can see, it recovers really quick when you change the angle of the subject. Rolling the lemon, if you don't know why I'm doing that, Google. So this healthy smoothie is just something that I came up with because we have been trying to be healthy for the past few months, or since early this year. Excuse me. And lemon is good for digestion, so that's why we try to make sure that we have lemon with all our smoothies. This is what I drink almost every day. And then since we are having the Korean pancakes that we bought from the Asian grocery store, we're also gonna be eating the Japanese Nissin cup noodles. And then with our healthy smoothie, we have the, we are gonna add the banana, which is actually a tiny bit healthier than apples, so that's why we prefer adding banana to our smoothie than apple. And that ripened part of the banana is due to its age of almost 7 days now. And when you're cooking pancakes, you make sure that the bubbles are showing and it's popping. Otherwise, you know that the other side is not yet cooked. Honey for, I don't know the reason why we need honey, but I know that it's healthy. I just don't know the health benefits, but I know it's healthy, so we're adding that. And then again, the oat milk. This is me multitasking now. While the noodles are cooking in the boiling water, I'm making pancakes in my smoothie. And here it is, the photo that we took using the phone. And again, that's just the original setting. We didn't change anything because we don't know how to use an Android yet. So yeah, we didn't change anything there. It's just the original setting when you go to the camera icon in the phone apps. We took the picture and that's what you got there. So thank you for watching our very professional review of the Realme GT Master. Comment below if you want more of these reviews. Bye!